Hey everyone, welcome back to Nintendo Treehouse Live at E3. I'm Rob, here with my colleagues Sam and other Rob and Scott, and also joined by the game's developer Motokuda-san and Koizumi-san, the producer. We're talking about Mario Odyssey again. I guess that should be obvious from the big board. And I had a little trouble playing and talking yesterday, so Motokuda-san has graciously offered to show me how it's done.
All right,
let's take a look at the Sand Kingdom at night here.
Let's
take a good look around.
Oh,
and then there's an oasis there in the distance. Let's go into town.
Doing
long jumps, dives, lots of different actions.
So
as you can see, the whole town's frozen and Mario is shivering himself.
It's worth mentioning that there are costumes in the game that will make Mario not shiver in the cold because they're warm enough.
So we've got a seed
here. While you're holding the seed, you can't throw your hat.
Okay.
Let's try planting it in this pot.
All
right, we've got a bud there.
That seems like the thing to do.
他にもなんかこう種がありそうな場所ってなんかないでしょう?
So you think there's somewhere else there might be a seed?
Well, seeing the two pots, there must be two other seeds hidden somewhere nearby, I'd assume. And actually, the oasis might not be a bad place to check because there are things growing there. Maybe something dropped a seed.
Seeds come from plants.
Oh, oasis in the Arizona, isn't it? That's right, let's head there.
Oh.
Careful!
Yeah, deserts are dangerous at night.
Yeah, these guys can really catch up on you because they just swarm. And if you're not paying attention to what's going on around you, you could actually have quite a collection of them sneaking up behind you before you even realize it.
Yeah.
You might hear the noise, but if you're focused on something else, you might not catch it.
And they just never stop.
What's this?
Oh no.
Poor Lakita was just fishing and he got trapped in the ice.
Wrong place, wrong time.
He looks pretty cold. Okay, let's see if we can find a seed. Can't see one.
I wonder if we could take a step on that ice for a moment though, just to appreciate how it looks with the. There's some stuff embedded in there as well.
ちょっと氷の上に踏み入ってみます?
滑りますね.
あの、このコインも。
この中にもここの国のコインが埋まってるんですけれども、 凍ってるので取れません。
And as you can see, there's some local coins in there, but with the water frozen, you can't get to them right now.
Hey, this came up yesterday. Are the coins here upside down triangles because of the inverted pyramid?
ここのコインがトライアングルになって
Yeah, it's
probably based off that, as you can see there, the inverted pyramid. It's probably based off that motif.
And something cool on top of that tree there.
じゃあこのアイテムを取ってみましょう。
So let's try getting this item.
Oh.
Careful.
Oh, yeah, they're super delicate to walk on.
So
you gotta get them all within the time limit.
So close.
まあ、中にはこういったちょっと難しい遊びっていうのもあるんですけれども、there'll
be some kind of difficult gameplay elements sometimes like that.
ここでご紹介したいちょっとモードがありまして、Nintendo Switch といえば、とあるモードが。
But since that was kind of hard, well, there's actually a special mode we can do on the Nintendo Switch, which might make it a bit easier, so maybe we'll try that right now?
Sounds great. Thank you.
Time to share the joy.
All right. Oh, does this mean I get to wear the extra hat?
じゃあサムも帽子をかぶります。
Nice.
Okay.
Perfect, thank you. So, can I throw the extra hat on now?
Ooh.
Yes! I've had my eye on these, they look so cool. All right, I'm gonna get dressed for business here.
Nice.
Ready. ready to save Peach.
So what inspired you to add two players simultaneous to this game, Otokura-san?
なんで同時で2プレイヤーできるようにしたいと思われたんでしょうか。
そうですね、任天堂スイッチのコントローラーをうまく使って、2人で協力するプレイっていうのを、目指しました。
So we wanted to, you know, have this co-op mode that would make good use of the Nintendo Switch controllers, since, you know, it comes with two of them.
And actually, if we hop back down to the ground for a moment, before we try the music puzzle, I just want to talk for a second about the motion control.
ちょっとやってみる前に、モーションコントローラーについて話したいんですけど。
はい、じゃあちょっと下を降りましょうか。
Perfect. So if we stay still here, folks will see the guide on the screen here. So our controls are quite different. So right now, I'm controlling Cappy, and Motokura-san's controlling Mario.
コントローの説明が出るように。
Pop those up here. Oh, there we go. So you can see here our controls are quite different, and we all have quite a range of movement. So Mario's got his traditional running and jumping abilities. He also has the ability to control the camera. He can't throw me without doing something special, which I'm not sure we're going to show here. But I have the ability to move Cappy and also look around and use the camera. And here I have full range of movement. I can just fly wherever my little hattie heart desires. And I think maybe get Cappy very dizzy. All right, should we try that puzzle again? What
does that say? Yes.
じゃあ先ほど失敗したあの音符のオブジェクトに挑戦してみましょう。
All right, yeah, let's take a little look at that music note challenge that didn't work too well before.
So I wonder, while we're giving this a go, I don't know that a hat has ever been a player character before. How was it for you designing the control scheme for the hat?
よいしょ。
Oh, let's do it! Whoop, whoop, okay. Almost got him. Oh, yeah, let's go. Oh, no, closer! Oh, I'm too low! I'm too low! Yes!
Just barely under the wire.
Oh, that's good. All right. But one thing that's kind of different about Cappy here, he can't actually collect the moon. I can just bounce around it, so Mario has to be there to finish the job.
じゃあちょっとここには種がなかったみたいなんで他のところに移動します。
So it looks like there wasn't a seed here after all, so maybe we'll go try out another location.
So one thing that's handy about Cappy here, he's invincible, so I can actually protect Mario as he's running around pretty nicely. As long as I'm feeling generous, I don't fly off in the distance.
Cappy は無敵ですから、マリオは防衛できますね。
ちょっと先の敵が出てきましたね。
Oh, no, here's those enemies from before.
You stay away from Mario. No. Leave him alone. Nope. And this is actually a really great way for just to play with maybe a friend who's not sure they want to try the full game yet. You say, hey, you know, try being Cappy for a bit and then decide if you want to be Mario.
やっぱり帽子のキャラクターが敵になってい
て、oh, no. Come here, you guys.
ゲームに慣れていない友達と一緒に遊びたいと思っていれば、ちょうど2人やってますね。
Yeah. そうですね。あの元々キャッピーマリオは一人の時のあの無敵なので、ちょっとバランスがいいんじゃないかなと思ってこうしました。
Yeah, that was certainly intentional on our part. You know, when you throw Cappy, he's invincible, and so we thought that would be a really good opportunity for people who aren't used to games to be able to play with someone else who's a little more advanced, knowing they won't get hurt. It's easier for them to give it a try.
And here we see that Cappy is the solution to the can't throw your hat while holding a seed problem.Seems like you spent a lot of time coming up with good ways to come up, have teamwork in the game. How was the development process for that like?
またあのいろいろとチームワークできそうですけど、あの開発の流れでなんか面白い発見がありましたでしょうか。
まずあのこれを採用する流れなんですけど、最初に、まあ、まずマリオのアクションを作ったんですけど、それを帽子にしようということで、その帽子の帽子を投げるオブジェクトにまあキャラクターをつけていく順番で決まっていきました。でまあ、そうなってくるんだったらもうこの人もう一個のコントローラーで操作できた方がいいだろうっていうふうなプロセスで決まっていました。
Yeah, it was a real natural evolution for us in the course of development because we knew that we wanted Mario to be able to throw something and then we thought, well, he's always wearing hats, so if he just throws his hat, that would be great. And once we got to that point, realized that people could have a more of an emotional attachment if it was also a character. And then once we realized it was a character, he should be able to move around himself. And so the multiplayer element really just fell into place.
Makes perfect sense.
It is really fun just flying around as a magic, all-powerful, invincible hat. I'm sorry. It's so fun to poke these guys.
You really mean to them, though.
They just look so cute when their skull spins around. And we noticed there, too, that the seed that we planted at the beginning of the segment has grown quite a bit as well, so it might be worth coming back to that. Maybe not now, but later.
So since we're able to bury that second seed now, there's another place I'd like to check out, so we're going to hop on this Jaxi.
I love riding the Jaxi, it's so fun. It's just so fast and so dangerous. And of course I can still fly away, but I think I'm going to sit tight.
Yeah.
Sort of get lost.
昨日のあのツリーハウスライブでも出てたと思います。
So I think you saw this on Treehouse Live yesterday as well.
So I know, Motocross-san, one thing that you mentioned, I think maybe in an interview earlier, was that some of the world here was inspired by a trip you took to Mexico.
で、さっきの取材で、モトクロさんがメキシコに行った旅のきっかけがあって、メキシコの国を作りたいというコメントがありましたけど。
はい。そうですね、あのすごいいろんな魅力的なところであったりマリオのアクションに活かせそうなところがたくさんありましたので、ぜひ作りたいと思いました。
Yeah, there were just so many like different wonderful and charming places there and so many think, you know, places that seemed like they'd be great opportunities for Mario type actions to be used.
Oh, and we're slippery here. I don't have to worry about that because I don't have feet, but yeah. Mario's definitely got a problem.
One of the things I find fascinating about this game is that when I'm playing in this area, I wish for there were Goombas, because Goombas' feet don't slip. And so here I am wishing for an enemy to use as a power-up.
Oh, careful. All right, so we took a little look up above us earlier, and there's some goodies pretty high. Oh, careful. There we go. Nice. Let's see here. Come back from jumping.
Yup.
And what's nice as well, since both of us have camera control, if one of us is doing a particularly complicated either series of jumps, or in Cappy's case, maybe trying to collect something really fast, if your partner is feeling generous, they can actually adjust the camera for you, so you don't even have to worry about that, and they'll just get a good angle for you to see. But teamwork's certainly important. You don't want to be fighting over the camera.
No.
Almost. Here, this angle looks good. So
nice.
Almost. Nice. So if we take a look over here.
Oh, look at all those.
That
is.
Definitely want to try and get over there.
Okay, so I'm going to get myself in position here. Let me know if I need to adjust, though.
Maybe just a little further. That's good. That's good.
That looks really far.
Good luck.
Yes! Yay! Teamwork!
These stacks of coins are really satisfying. We can die a whole bunch now and not worry about it.
Now, for the record, that would be possible in single player, but it's much easier in two player with a cooperative friend.
Definitely harder. All right, so there we're.
じゃあこれで、ですかね、森のステージに行きましょうか。
So, should we head to the wooded stage, maybe?
Oh, sure, here? Absolutely. Let's swap systems really quick. I'll return this to you.
そうしましょう。
And there's some things in the Wooded Kingdom that we definitely wanted to get your guys' input and insight on, because there's some interesting stuff going on in the Wooded Kingdom.
Yeah.
All right, so let's get set up here. So we should be able to swap the feed over to the Wooded Kingdom, and we can hop into some gameplay there again. All right, here we go. So we are back in the Wooded Kingdom here. And one thing I think we definitely need to talk about with you guys is that T-Rex that we saw down in the deep wood. Can you tell us a little bit more about the inspiration for adding a T-Rex and tell our viewers a bit more about, you know, what came into bringing things like that into a Mario game?
深い森には恐竜もいると思いますが、なんで恐竜をマリオのゲームに入れたいと思ったんでしょうか？
あの、今回のゲームのテーマが驚きなので、あの、スーパーマリオワールドのあの恐竜ランドとはちょっと違ったデザインというのにチャレンジしています。
So you know the theme of this game is obviously surprises. So you know previously in Super Mario World we had you know Dino Island, Dino Land, but we wanted to try for this game, you know kind of a different design of dinosaur, something we hadn't seen in a Mario game before.
きっとこのなんかこう地球上にもまだこう恐竜が住んでいるところとかまだ僕らが見たことないようなところっていうのがまだまだ残ってるんじゃないかなと思います。
And, you know, I think, you know, maybe there are places on Earth where dinosaurs still exist, and maybe we just haven't found them yet.
I'm going to keep my fingers crossed, because if it's a dinosaur, after playing this game, I want to put a hat on it and then take
totally.
It for a little ride. We can be friends.
Now, I've been curious for months about the sky here. Can you
yes.
can you tell me about why we have it's huge sort of sci-fi looking sky? Are those real mountains on the other side of it? Where are we? And what's going on here?
それの方はちょっとなんか怪しいですけど、なんかサイファイっぽいドームのような形になっていますが、どうでしょうか？
はい、ここの国はあの巨大な温室で覆われています。こう結婚式で使う花っていうのを、育てているところなんです。
So this kingdom here, this land here is actually basically a giant greenhouse, and it's where the flowers that will ultimately be used in the wedding ceremony.Are being raised.
Mm-hmm. で、細かくはお伝えできないんですけれども、あの、いろんな国にまだそういった、あの、結婚式で使うものっていうものが関係するものが出てきます。
And I can't go into too many details, but basically every kingdom will have something within it that will be related to the wedding and some connection to that.
Mm-hmm. At least I guess it's nice that Bowser is pulling out all the stops, sparing no expense. So I'm going to hop up this way.And one thing that we haven't really shown, I mean, I think we've shown a little bit in some of our earlier demos, but swimming we haven't really shown in too much detail. And there's a spot here where I can take a nice swim, but there's also another spot I want to visit, a different kind of environmental texture that woo-hoo-hoo, oh. I'm very excited about. I want to roll down, but I'm scared.
Don't fall. Woo.
There we go. See, Daredevil's fun sometimes. Just see if you can do it. Come here, buddy. I got to get my favorite again. Oh, no, come here, bud. Yes.
You always hurt the ones you love.
Sorry, I think this is one of my favorite capture targets. I love the uproots. So I'm going to take him for a stroll. So we're actually going to head down this way. And I guess I want to keep this guy, but I also want to be safe, so I'm going to leave him here for now and head off to this little corner here. And we've got another little friend to meet.
Fire, bro. I love this fire.
Yeah, I know with the different environmental animations that you brought in and the different textures with a lot of very realistic fire and water and just I think looking at the aesthetics overall of this series, can you tell us a little bit more about the kind of overall art direction concept that you guys had as you're working on this game?
また、ヒノエフェクトも結構うまくできてると思いますし、水もちょっと気に入ってますので、まあ全体的にアートスタイルについて何かコメントいただけますか？
はい。あの今回はキノコ王国っていうのを飛び出してマリオがいろんな国を冒険しますのであの自分たちが実際外国に行った時に感じるなんていうんですかねドキドキする違和感というものを表現しようとしています
So, you know, since this is a game about Mario going on a big adventure and leaving the Mushroom Kingdom we wanted to basically create a world that would bring out the same kind of emotions that you know you normally have when you visit a foreign land, that kind of feeling of you know things being kind of different, but it's very, very exciting.
アートディレクターと日々相談しながらどれぐらいのそのなんでしょうアートの幅を持たせたらよいかとかゲーム全体でバランスを取ったらいいかということを話しています。
So, you know, there's been a lot of day-to-day discussion with the art director, like, how far should we go? How different should it look from the Mushroom Kingdom? And, like, we focused a lot on getting that balance right.
Mm. And the topic of looks, this guy looks fantastic. He really takes care of himself, too. That shell is
so shiny.
So shiny. And I do love that these guys just have this cute little hop. They don't even walk.
Yeah.
They just bounce it all.
Well, which is true to the series. The Hammer Brothers and cousins are always sort of hopping around.
It's not even just an act. They just do it because they love it. So I'm actually going to leave him here because I want to operate the switch. And much as it's fun throwing fireballs around, it's not really helping me in this case. So I'm going to leave him here. Get the switch here. And as you showed in an earlier segment, what I can actually do is grab my capture target back. He was just kind of sitting there recovering for a bit. So now that I've done what I need to do, I can hop my merry way this way. And this is actually a really nice high vantage point where we can take another look at where we were in our second segment.
And there's the brutal ship up there.
With all those.
Hovering menacingly.
Piranha plants giving me problems. But there's a little ridge over here, and for this I'm going to want to grab that uproot. Hi, buddy, I didn't forget you. Oh, I'm back with my uproot family here. So we're going to do a little bit of careful platforming here. And this is definitely another case where you need the right capture target to complete a little puzzle. And yeah, he's up there. Okay. Got another one. Yeah, plants and fire don't mix. No, leave me alone. Please leave me alone. So,
did you bring an Uproot to a Fire Brothers fight?
I did, but that's okay. He's a little boss, and he's going to make work. Here we go. So one thing I think that's really fascinating about this game, coming back to the kind of sandbox style that we had in 64 and Sunshine, is you guys had to create these really big, complex spaces that were densely packed with content and make sure that it all found fun and nothing felt kind of extraneous. Could you tell us a little bit about the process of developing spaces like that so that they're really fun and they work?
またあのスーパーマリオ64やスーパーマリオサンシャインの
箱庭
スタイルに戻ってそういうあのゲームの要素はあの密度高く楽しくできるような空間を作らなきゃいけないと思うんですがどういうふうにあのそういうような空間を作るんでしょうか。
はい、そのなんだろう遊びっていうものを常々たくさん試作していてその遊びを、並べてステージっていうのを作るそれを作ったものを遊んで面白いものをまた載せていくっていうのが基本になっています。
So kind of the basic way we do it is we create lots of different prototypes of different like gameplay ideas. You know, we put them in a stage. You know, we play through it to find which is fun, and then you know we just kind of go from there, building on the ones that seem fun.
で、ここの国の特徴はその作っていく中で、あの予想外の場所であるとか、あの想定していなかったような通路とかができたので。それをなるべく活かすような、形にしています。
And so, you know, one thing with this kingdom is we ended up creating a lot of different, you know, pathways and different ways you could go that were in pretty unexpected places. And so we tried to emphasize that with everything we did when creating this stage.
And on the subject of other pathways, in case anybody missed our second segment, just want to hop into these binoculars again to give a look at how much is here that we haven't seen. And really, it's hard to truly emphasize how much what we're showing here at E3 and on Treehouse Live is only a small portion, even within these kingdoms, of how much there is to do. And right now, I'm seeing some other spaces. I'm really only seeing a corner of the other spaces here. There's a lot more to get up to in this kingdom, but nothing I'm allowed to show right now. There's only one more thing that I can bounce over to in this space. And that is taking a look at some of the water. So, I'm gonna head down this way, get a couple more coins, and this little pond, get them all! There we go.
And can you catch some of the fish on
yeah,
the screen?
Yeah, I see those guys.
So I love there's realistic fish here in a world that also has cheap sheeps and stuff.
It's yeah, I feel like this might have been really confusing for Mario when he saw these things, like, you're not red, you're not shaped like beach balls.
Do you even have eyes?
But I know the first time I came in here and was just swimming around and following this school of fish, I was so distracted by the space that I almost let Mario drown. I wonder, can you tell us a little bit more about the design work that went into things here, like, say, the water effects in the game?
このような綺麗な水を作るにはどういうような考え方だったでしょうか？
はい。いつもこうそのプレイヤーが、プレイヤーの性能というのにこだわって作っています。
So, you know, the main thing we focus on is the ability of the player when we're creating different environmental elements.
今回はそのプレイヤーが取り巻く環境、砂のところでちょっと汚れたりであるとか、毒に触ると汚れたりとか、プレイヤーにの周りのものに対してもこだわって作っています。
And we want to make sure that there's also, you know, the things in the environment will affect the player, like the sand in the Sand Kingdom can get on Mario, and then obviously he's in the water, he can get wet.
水もあのマリオが気持ちよく動いてそこに反応するっていうすごいあのいい例だと思います。
And you know, I think, you know, especially the responsiveness you can feel from the water as you swim from it is a very good example of creating that very kind of intuitive interaction between the player and the environment.
毎日良くなってるので多分今日も良くなってると思います。
And I think, you know, that's actually something that gets a bit better every day. It's probably even better than it was yesterday in the game.
Yeah, it's really impressed me watching as new builds come in from you guys, just how much, I mean, love is really going into all the little details of this game and really bringing the environments to life. So I think, I hope folks are really excited to see them when you guys have finished all the development work.
Absolutely.
All right, now I'm going to actually hop into this warp pipe that's been teasing us over here. and this space as well, it's really interesting because it's partly swimming, it's a side-scrolling with the fuzzies and...
those fuzzies.
Also my oxygen level.
Yeah.
But it's almost like there's a little bit of a curve to the water on the front edge. All right. There we go. Just gonna stay here. I do love, too, the kind of water effect on Mario's outfit after he's gotten into the water.
Yeah, okay. So slick.
Look at these guys. Hey, Fuzzies, I need you to go. Wait for the next cycle. Okay.
Go, 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 go.
Up. There we go. Okay. Okay, I need you guys to go. Oh, I missed it. All right, oh, I'm burning. Okay. Mm.
No!
No, it's a little too high. All right, let's give that another go. All right. Not good there. I don't want those coins, though. Oh.
Well, since this is our last Mario Odyssey segment for Treehouse Live this year, I'd like to just ask if Motokoto-san and Koizumi-san, if you had any final comments for our viewers while Sam is playing through the segment. No. Any last words?
これで E3 の最後のトリアスライブのオディシーのセグメントになりますが、何か最後に小泉さん、元倉さんからなんかコメントありますでしょうか。
元倉さん。
はい、じゃあ僕から。
Here we go.
All right, I'll start.
今回お見せできたものっていうのはすごいごく一部なんですけれども、まだまだ驚きというものがたくさんありますので、今作の帽子を投げて敵やものを操って。いろんなところを探索、地球を冒険、探索していただければなと思います。
You know, I want to say that, you know, what we've been able to show you this time is just, you know, it's a very small portion of the game, and there's so many more surprises waiting for you, so many more, you know, places you'll be able to go and explore, so many more things you'll be able to throw your head at and control. So I hope people really enjoy that when it comes out.
Nice. Well done, Sam.
All right.
はい、
Get out of here.
E3 の3日間で一番実はお伝えしたかったのはこれだったんですけども、あの任天堂スイッチのいつでもどこでも誰とでもの3つが揃ってる新しい新作マリオですので、驚きを探した新しいマリオの旅に皆さん楽しみにしてください。
So what I've really been trying to get across these three days at E3 here is that Super Mario Odyssey on the Nintendo Switch is a game that you can play anytime, anywhere, with anyone. And I hope everyone enjoys looking for all of the discovery and surprise that the game has to offer.
Thank you so much. It's been a real pleasure.
Thank you. It really
Thank
has.
You.
Just going to hang out with my little buddy here.
All right.
And relax.
And that's where we're going to wrap it up for this segment. So thanks for watching, everybody. Up next, we have Splatoon 2 Turf War. And stay tuned.